This is a CC Radio podcast.
Welcome to the Countdown Podcast. Today we are going to review some TV for you. What, you ask? The Witcher, I reply. My name is Wayne.
And my name is Paul. Straight into it then for this Netflix series, which dropped about the 20th of December from memory.
Pretty recent.
It's an action fantasy drama series created by Lauren Schmidt.
Good one.
For Netflix. And it's based on the book series of the same name by Polish writer Andrzej Sapkowski.
I was wondering how you're going to do with that one. Good one.
I should do better than that, given that is my heritage as
well. Yes, aren't you, Paul?
Just the 8 episodes in the first season, and it stars, of course, Henry Cavill as the Witcher himself.
Superman.
Geralt of Rivia. Anya Charlotra as Yennefer, Freya Allen, and Myanna Boering, who is from The Descent.
Okay.
She's the head maid.
I sort of remember her.
Then there's a bunch of other people you probably recognize as character actors for around the place from bits and pieces. Each episode's about an hour long, and we got to, respectively, Wayne saw 5 episodes, I saw 6. So we're not going to spoil anything at this
start. Not a full season review.
General, quick sort of overview, 5 minutes or so. And then we're going to go into spoilers up to episode 5 in the back half of this review, if you're at all interested in playing along at home. Wayne, good luck here. What's The Witcher about?
Yeah, okay. The Witcher follows the stories of Geralt of Rivia, as you mentioned, a monster-hunting witcher who is mutated and lives much longer than a normal human. Also Yennefer, a sorceress of the Lodge who comes from humble and somewhat horrible beginnings to find beauty, power, and long life. And Ciri, and she's a princess of the realm. And essentially, this is a story about how the Witcher struggles to find his place in a world where people often prove more wicked than beasts as he rides across the continent on his horse Roach, looking for work and slaying pussy. Paul?
Not the word I thought we're going to end that sentence with. All right then, Wayne. So, 5 episodes in. Mm. What are you thinking of The Witcher?
Okay, so I think because Paul told me a little bit about the show. Well, we just discussed it briefly before I started watching it. Paul said the first episode was pretty spec.
Yeah.
Right?
I thought the first episode was really, really good.
And I agree. The second episode is
not so good.
Not so good because it's like it's all Exposition City. The third episode, and I agree with all those, right? The third episode, I was like, first of all, it's a very slick, very violent, very well-made thing.
Mostly.
It doesn't feel, for some reason, as quality as Game of Thrones.
Definitely not.
But it's got a lot of crap in it, and the stuff that they do relatively well.
That's the inevitable comparison that people are going to make with Game of Thrones just having finished.
That's right.
This is the reply. I heard it sort of advertised / couched in that way. This is the new show for Game of Thrones fans. And I'm like,
I hate doing that. I hate hearing that and doing that because it's like two shows are always usually different. So, I mean, this one here, definitely. The third episode, I have no idea what the fuck is going on. I had to wind it back. Go, who is this guy and what's happening there? It was very, very complex, and I thought it was very hard to follow. Mind you, I'm not that clever. But I'm telling you also, I still think that a normal person who has no knowledge of the game.
Have you played the game?
Never.
Never have I either.
Never read the books. Nothing of that shit.
So we got nothing. We come into this completely open-minded. We're not fans of the series, be that book or game. So I think you're at a disadvantage.
Definitely, because all I heard was that of the game was that it's a game about a witcher. And I didn't know what a witcher was. And in the game, you can pork people. That's about it. That's all I knew. All right?
Amazingly, Wayne still hasn't installed it yet on his computer.
Well, that's the thing, though. I suggest, as you mentioned, if you don't know the source material like we don't, you're probably going to have a little trouble with it. And apparently, even according to what I've read, it doesn't even follow the books necessarily and things like that. So, having said all that, it's a little bit like Game of Thrones, because the first 3 episodes of Game of Thrones are fucking bewildering with the amount of shit that you don't know what's going on.
Well, they would have been for you, and I know that they were for my partner when we watched them together.
Yeah, if you'd read the books, you wouldn't have.
But I've read the books, so for me, I was very well placed and appreciating it on a different level. So I get it that if you're a fan of the games, I'm sure, and in fact, a good friend of mine is a fan of the games, and he just said, you got to persevere, because it gets good.
This might be that, because at Game of Thrones, after the third episode, luckily there's this doco online that you can, on YouTube, which is like 10 minutes long, and it explains the first 3 episodes. You're like, yes! You know? And that's actually something you should watch after the first 3. Anyway, this one here, I suspect might be much the same, because after the confusing to me, I had to go look up a plot synopsis.
I went back and read a bit about it to sort of go, what's going on here?
Mm.
And there's something we'll talk about again? Spoilers, which I had started to twig to but hadn't connected the dots with fully.
Yes.
That took place by the end of episode 3.
3, okay, so that's how long it took for you. See, that's the thing. Game of Thrones has people like Ned Stark, whereas The Witcher has like Strigabor and Vanyell of Bruges and fucking...
Yennefer is the only easy one.
Yennefer, even that like sounds like a joke. But yes, so that's it's automatically a complex thing, but I will persevere and I will finish the season. Because well, I think
the fact there's only 8 episodes really helps that. Because I'm so close now anyway.
Exactly. You may as well just knock it over. Exactly.
And whereas I have to admit, if we go back to one of the last Netflix shows we reviewed,
yeah.
Dark Crystal, Age of Resistance, I never got around to finishing.
I fucking backed off immediately. I was like, this is fine. But
I think it was 10
me.
Episodes that, well, maybe even 12. And I'm like, it's too far to the end. Maybe one day I will, but I didn't love it enough to continue with it.
Yeah, it just wasn't for me. I mean, the fantasy thing has to be really good to snag me anyway. And I think this is. I think this is good enough to make me continue watching. I will tell you it's a bit fucking harsh for my liking. It's very, very violent.
Well, that part I like.
Yeah, I imagine that's what most people will like.
All right, so look, can we add a couple other general things and then get into specifics in the spoiler section? I think Henry Cavill is well cast.
Oh, is he ever.
I think he's having a great time.
Do you know the history of his...
Apparently, he lobbied
fan.
For this.
Yes, he's a huge fan. He plays the games. He read the books. And he said, I want to be this guy.
Yeah, apparently he turned up to the showrunner's office and said, it's me. I want to be this guy. I'm a gamer. I know all the lore about these games. Play them all. Mm. Give it to me. And they went, sorry, no.
Who's saying no to Superman?
Well, that's the thing. And then... Basically, when casting call went out, he came back again and said, well, can I at least read for it? And she said, I can't believe that we got Superman to read for a role. And we thought, oh, well, if you're prepared to go that far, well, you can read for it. And he nailed it.
Of course he nailed it.
Yeah.
He's been practicing it.
And then he got cast. So, yeah, he's absolutely...
Is that a story? I mean, like, if you're a casting director, it's like, look, Superman wants to do this role. And they're like, what? I was going to use fucking some other cracker, but this dude, absolutely... I mean, I don't know. It works for him to say, I worked for the role. As opposed to everyone wanted Superman.
Yeah, but that's the story she told. So the interview I read was with her, not with him.
Okay, pretty good. Pretty good.
That's pretty. And she, I had to be honest, there's nothing. We don't have a spot for you here. But then she changed the tune when she eventually let him read.
I wonder who got booted out.
Yeah, I don't think that. I don't think they had cast Superman. Anyone else. But yeah.
Yeah.
Apparently, the first call got 600 applications for the role of Geralt.
Exactly.
600 actors thought that. Yeah, this is my break.
That would have been a room full of beefcake, wouldn't it? Long-haired beefcake.
You would assume it went over a few days, this particular cast. And look, of course, I don't interview all 600. That would have cut a whole bunch of people straight away. But anyway, you're right. It would have been a very amusing day or two in the casting office. So I think he's great in the role.
Mm-hmm.
I think the other people are all fine. Like Yennefer, the woman playing Yennefer, must have been awkward as fuck for her the first couple of episodes, playing with a big rock or whatever in the corner of her mouth.
She stuck it in her... Yeah, she's
plastic
weird,
in the corner of her mouth and then the shoulder
the
raised.
Shoulder thing, yeah.
Speaking as a man who's currently battling a dodgy back, it's not much fun to sit there with everything out of position. So, you know, hats off to her for the physicality of that.
When she becomes the beautiful woman, spoilers.
Which is inevitable.
It's inevitable. It's sort of telegraphed all the way through the show. I still don't think she's all that, but I understand what they've done with her. Like, she was so horrendously disfigured to start with. It now becomes...
Oh, she's attractive, Anya Shalotra.
She's fine. So it's...
Not that that's what it's about, but obviously it's meant to be this contrast between how she was and how she turns out.
Of course.
And she's so beguiling that, you know, kings are dropping everything to get her as their personal mage.
Yeah.
Which is
a tough role to pull off.
Yeah, very much. Especially in a medieval fantasy type realm where everyone's grotty and dirty.
Mm-hmm,
and, yeah.
Exactly. So, yeah. No, I think that if you're curious about this show and you want to know if it's for you, I do think you should watch it, but you might need to do a little extra legwork to make sure you're following the plot and its characters. If you're willing to do that, you will probably like this show, if you suspect you like it.
That's fair. I'm on the fence overall. I don't think it's great. I think there's potential. I'm close enough. I'll certainly finish this season. If the last couple of episodes stick the landing, then I'll be back for season 2.
Mm-hmm.
If it really... There's a couple of episodes we'll talk about in spoilers, which I think were really not well constructed or put together.
Yeah, yeah.
If they're more like that, then I might not be back yet. So I'm very much on the fence, and that's what my final score will ultimately reflect.
The first season usually has to do all the heavy lifting, because it's like, you know, this is this, and introducing that, and exposition here, and that sort of shit. At least...
Well, it's got to set the world up.
That's right.
Right? And this does a lot of talking about the world and only shows you snippets of it.
Yep.
So I think that's kind of where it falls down. That might be budgetary. But it doesn't do as good a job, I don't think, sorry to compare, but to Game of Thrones is the closest.
No,
comparison.
Game of Thrones is a higher quality production, is basically what it is. But yeah, this is still cool and worth a look.
All right, there we are. That's our final thoughts. That's our summary thoughts on The Witcher. If you're interested in or have seen enough of it, then follow us through on the other side of this spoiler warning. All right then, so you're here, you've seen it, or you don't care, Wayne, where do you want to go detail-wise in terms of the plot?
My first question was, and this is my issue with episode 3, did I miss something or did they jump back in time? What happened was, he seems to, in the first two episodes, meet the minstrel or the bard.
Yes.
And then, you know, then they go on their journey, whatever this, that. Then in the third episode, It's like he's already known the bard so well that he becomes his bodyguard at this ball or whatever they go to.
That's the fourth episode.
Is it the fourth episode? Yeah. Sorry, the fourth episode. So I'm like, wait, so, but it,
can I help you?
Yes.
There's three timelines in the show.
So, and also the Ciri, her mom.
Queen Calanthe, her grandmother.
Yes.
She is.
Oh, it's her grandmother.
Yes.
So that young girl wasn't actually that young.
No, so the girl in the fourth episode, that's her mum and her dad.
It looks exactly like her. Is it her playing her?
No.
Fuck, it looks exactly like her.
They're very similar actresses.
These white women. Anyway, so all right, I was like, wait, isn't that girl? So that's why that confused me.
Now, I'm not going to play the whole, you're so silly. No, because I had to read. I was like, why? Hang on, we got picture of these royals when they were old in age. And then later in the scene, I think with Yennefer. No, Yennefer's the earliest storyline.
Yes, okay, right? Yes.
So she's the first.
Okay, that
then
makes
the Geralt
sense.
Stuff is in the middle, and then the Ciri stuff's at the end. That's the three timelines.
And they're playing them all simultaneously?
Yeah, and they're bouncing. And they don't give you that until the third episode starts to drop clues, and there's a picture of a royal kids, and they're kids in one scene, and then the adults in another. And I'm like, whoa, that's weird.
Yeah!
Do they just look alike? Is that the story there? And then it's actually referred to. I realize because Queen Calanthe is played by Jodhee May. Mm-hmm. I think that's how you say her name, Jodhee May.
Yeah.
She's the younger sister in The Last of the Mohicans. And so I recognized her, right?
Yes, yes,
and
yes.
So I was a bit more interested. Like, oh, she was on. Oh, she's been killed off in the first episode. All right. And then she's back again. Now we see her a bit younger as this battling warrior queen. And suddenly it all kind of fell into place.
So
to
you
a
found
degree.
That she looked younger. For me, it looks the same. But anyway.
They've done a bit of an effort.
Only now that if I look for it, I'll see.
It was more the vitality that she brought to the role. And then that scene also, that's where they get together.
Yes.
That's when he proposes
that's
and
right.
she accepts as
which
well.
Which is cool. And I got that. But to me, they did not make that easy enough for me to understand, for me to then also enjoy the plot. I was like, who's... Okay. And you know what? The bard then doesn't fucking age. Because he looks the same in that scene.
Well, no, he hasn't... They haven't jumped ahead to that. So Geralt is still in that middle timeline. He's now met Yennefer. Yennefer's caught up to him, but like you said, she doesn't age either. But they haven't got to where he's chasing Ciri or knows that where she is. So that stuff's all still taking place later than everything else we're seeing.
But it still means that... Fuck. All right. Yeah. All right.
Because he turns up to that ball.
Yes.
And he gets the law of surprise or whatever it's called.
That's right.
I can't remember what that.
Where he says, whatever you don't have or whatever, you
the
can
next
have
thing
is mine.
And then, I'm pregnant.
Yeah. So now it's, oh, shit, I got this fucking kid.
Yeah. He's like, I don't care. And I don't believe in destiny. And he says to his mate, and he goes, if you don't, cataclysm could befall us all. And we also see the seeds for why the Nilf, whatever they're called, hate that realm, Sintra.
Yes.
Because Calanthe dismisses their envoy.
That's right.
And she shoots all of her daughter. Yeah. Yes. So there's some nice little seeds there. I really liked that episode. That brought me right back because I thought episode two was terrible.
If they explained it somehow better, I probably would have liked that a lot.
It's very Westworldy. Westworld doesn't ever bother to stop.
Westworld's not that fucking good.
I like Westworld. I like Westworld a lot. Westworld doesn't stop to ever tell you in the first season that it's taking place over these distinct timelines. Same with this show. It hasn't bothered to tell you. You've got to pick it up.
Having said that, I think Westworld did a much better job of that.
Okay.
Because it kept me... This one I was like, oh, just confused. But there you are. Okay, that's helped me out and I'll definitely watch it more now.
When that realization happened, I was much more interested. But episode two, like, I agree with you. Very exposition heavy, very Yennefer based and sort of sidelining the other two much more interesting storylines.
You don't see shit all of Geralt in that one.
Yeah, that was a terrible episode, I thought. Mm. And it almost lost me. Three
risky second
better.
Episode.
The dark sort of horror elements of that sort of thing he was hunting towards the end of the episode helped me. And that's when I realized, hang on. And then four was great because now they're starting to come together the timelines. Five, I fell asleep in. Five was terrible.
Really?
I thought, which is where you're up to.
I only just saw it, so I was like, oh, okay, I'll keep it up too. But I know what you mean.
I mean, it got Yennefer and Geralt together.
Yes.
So that was interesting, I guess. But otherwise, I'm like, this story's boring.
Well, when I watched it, I was like...
I had to go back and watch it.
I didn't even know that there was different timelines. Like, oh, I did, but not like that. So I'm like, where's this bit? I'm just watching it.
I think it was four when Yennefer sort of abandons the queen and tries, and then realizes she does want a kid. And so that becomes a driving force for her character after that.
That's right.
That was a really cool scene when she's being hunted by that thing and the assassin.
Agreed.
I dug that.
Yeah, the cool shit in it will get you through, I think.
It is few and far between in places. I will say episode six was a good standalone episode. In a sense. Like, it's advancing the Ciri plot, but it has more of Yennefer and Geralt. I'll just say that. And yeah, I like that episode. It came together quite well.
Do you feel like it has a Monster of the Week vibe to it sometimes?
Yeah, and here's the thing I wanted to say, which I probably should have said in the first half of the episode.
Yeah.
The first book is a series of short stories written by...
Oh, is it?
Yeah, the Polish writer. Mm-hmm. So I don't know whether it's following all of those, but it's picked up that style. Short stories. I think the first two books, at least the first one, is a short story collection, and then it becomes novels. So I hope... the season or the series will follow a similar path.
I read somewhere that in the books, Yennefer doesn't even turn up until like the second book or something.
Okay, there you go.
So that's why
maybe they are crushing the first two books together. Because I know that the first two published were sort of short story collections, and then they become, and that was back in the mid-80s. So this guy, he must be 60, 65, maybe 70 years old now, the author.
Oh, really? So it's still running as good.
Oh, cool. You know, that said, George R.R. Martin's also 70, hasn't published a book in 8 fucking years.
Don't get Paul started.
Sorry, that was my fault. I started that.
Fair enough.
Yes, and I stand completely resolute about that.
I stand resolute, motherfucker!
So does Wayne. I think that part's, it's interesting enough, and we're talking about it, and I'm appreciating it on certain levels, but God, it's slow in places.
I think that's the one thing that will probably bring this down. If you haven't got patience, which I don't, you may not stick with it, but it's worth a try, definitely. See if you can make it 5 episodes. See if you can make it 5 episodes, and if you still dig it, you probably go all the way
that's
through.
That's 5 hours. That's a big investment.
It's a huge investment. That's what I'm saying.
I think the rule of thumb, generally speaking, for TV shows is 3 episodes.
That's the one we always follow, right? Yep. If it doesn't nail you in 3 episodes, it's done.
Yeah, you don't bother. Yeah. It's not for you. Move on to something more. In this golden age of television, which obviously last week we talked about, this week just gone, we've talked about the best and worst of TV of 2019. There's so much good stuff out there.
That is it.
You can't keep up with it all. So you have to be ruthless.
Absolutely.
With your time.
And you can't even like, because you could easily get a list off anyone and say, I got to see all these things. And then your life is gone.
Which is
it'll steal your fucking
kind of what we gave you.
Totally.
Can I also add a big shout out to the end of the first episode's sword fight, which is one of the best sword fights I've ever seen filmed in any medium.
Which one? 6?
No, episode 1.
Oh, yeah.
When he fights the cronies in the town. Oh my God, it was so well put together. He's so well constructed. Henry Cavill sells the physicality of it. But the camera work and the way the sword and the gore and the light, oh, was magnificent.
I'm going to have to look at that again because he's using essentially a 200 broadsword, kind of. Someone out there will probably correct me. But he's using it like he's reverse gripping it and shit, which is cool.
Yep.
Like it's really excellent. So yeah, I know what you mean. This is cool. This motherfucker's big too, man. He's Superman. But
he is Superman.
But yeah, that's why he's nailing it.
Like, yeah.
How else would you not have used him if he worked? Anyway.
All right. Well, that's pretty much all I wanted to say about The Witcher. It's not the most comprehensive review, but that's right. It's just a taster for whether you would like to get into this or not, especially you Game of Thrones-ers out there who are jonesing for something else that might fill the considerable void.
I say don't look for this to fill your void. Just look to see if you fill your void.
Normally speaking, Wayne wants to fill everyone's void.
If only that weren't true. but yeah, it's going to be just its own good thing for you. I think it's worth watching. If you like The Thrones, just watch this, but don't expect it to be a Thrones. There you go.
All right, fair enough. Wayne, give us a score then. Out of 100, what are you rating The Witcher and any final thoughts?
72.
Okay, that's generous.
And, no, 72 because I like some of these things I have to watch for the show. And I know I'm acutely aware that I have to watch it. But The Witcher, I'm like, no, I'm happy to actually.
Okay.
Like,
yeah, because this wasn't originally on our slate. We were going to do a movie that opened on Boxing Day. And then I said, well, how about this instead? Because you weren't that keen on Jumanji and I was totally keen, you asshole.
We can still go somewhere with it.
I'll still see it. Don't worry. For me, I'm giving this a sort of 3-star just 59.
Oh, shit. Really?
Yeah. Like I said, I could
hasn't
fall
impressed
off.
You yet.
Could fall off. That said, the last two episodes, Stick the Landing. Like a show that we talked about, I'm not going to mention it now, on the episode Just Go On did, then it would elevate my score significantly. So
very much.
There we go. All right. That's our review of The Witcher. Did we get it right? Did we get it wrong? Are you a big fan of the books or the series? And do you have anything to say to us? Let us know via Twitter at TheCountdownPC, on email at TheCountdownPodcast@gmail.com. You can like and follow the show on podbean.com where we host it and check out our Australian website with a bunch of other great Australian shows, ccradio.com.au. And that is it for today. Thank you so much for joining us. My name is Paul.
My name is Wayne.
And this has been The Soundboard, which doesn't need to be used very much today. So let's just go with something like...
How about don't use the cunt at all? Word.
Bitch, please.
There you go.
Sometimes you make it too easy. Catch you next week.
Yeah.